الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة من يطيع الله ورسوله فقد رشد واهتدى ومن يعصهما فإنه قد غوى وإنه لا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئا إن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وإن خير الأمور أوازمها وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم قال الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم فلما ترى الجمعان قال أصحاب موسى إنا لمدركون قال كلا إنما يا ربي سيهدين. My dear brothers and sisters, these two verses from Surah Shura, which is 26th chapter of Quran, verse number 61 and 62. In the first ayah, a situation has been described in the most eloquent way, because the language of Quran is the most eloquent language, most precise, most eloquent. If we know the language, we can go to the depth of the meaning of what has been described. So the army of Pharaoh is chasing the people of Bani Israel, and they came very close. So what they are saying, Kala Ashabu Musa, Inna Lamudrakun. They are going to get us. Inna, indeed, they are going to get us. They are asking Musa, what is going to happen? Because they are chasing, and in front, there is this huge body of water. There is no way out. But look at how Musa alayhi salam responds. He says, Kala, Kalla. Emphatic no. No, by no means. Inna maya rabbi sayahdeen. Indeed, my Lord is going to guide us, is going to help us, is going to find out a way for us. These two verses are enough for us to learn the lesson that we need to learn in the current situation. But this is not simply a statement that Musa alayhi salam has made. In this statement, there is tremendous faith that he has in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not a simple thing that when you are so close to seeing that your enemies are going to take you over, you still say no. This was the same faith that our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he was in the cave of Hira, and the kuffar, they used to come so close, he said, no, there is no need to worry. My Lord is with us. So, the first lesson that we all can draw from this guidance from Quran is that what matters is how is the state of our faith, our iman? How strong is our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How eager we are to look into the guidance that Quran gives us and the lessons that we can learn from the sunnah of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This faith cannot come by me giving a speech or by you listening a khutbah. So that's the first thing. Strengthening our faith, our iman, our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there are so many ways that our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has showed us based on the guidance that he received from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So both things are with us, the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So every one of us, if we are not used to reading Quran and getting the guidance from it, we need to make it part of our daily routine. Opening Quran, reading it, trying to understand what Quran is saying, and then trying to reflect how this guidance can be a practical guidance for me in my life. That's point number one. Point number two is that a lot of time the guidance will appear to be theoretical, and we will think, how can we implement? That's where the Sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam comes. In most difficult situation, he was always confident that Allah is going to help. And he gave us, his whole life is an open book about which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has very clearly said that this is the best example that a human being can present, that you can find on the face of this earth in the entire human history. In the entire human history. So, connecting ourselves with the seerah, with the life of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, these two things. Then, there are so many other things, like getting up in 2/3 of the night and bowing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeking His help, seeking His forgiveness, reminding ourselves that the more our connection with Allah is going to be strong, the more we will be entitled to His mercy. Also, spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, opening our wallets to helping the causes that are found in our community, for the sake of Islam, for the service of Islam. Wonderful efforts are being done by organizations, and a lot of us, we say, yeah, they are doing good work. That's not enough. We have to support them. For example, in the area of Dawah and outreach, a lot of good work is done by Gain Peace. We can learn from them. We can invite them to tell us how we can make dawah. How can we connect with people who live around us in our neighborhoods? Almost on a daily basis, at least twice every week, we are reminded here in this masjid about connecting to our neighbors. When I moved to this neighborhood a couple of years ago, I went to everybody, the 5 houses that are in that half block. And every 2-3 months, I go to them with a gift, just say hello and hi. So last week, I was not at my house. My neighbor from the right side, he came with his 2 daughters, with a bag of gift, and then he gave a card, which says, after our names, in regard to America's unfortunate new executive order on immigrants, we want to show our support for you, our Muslim neighbors. We are glad you are part of our country. And as Christians, we do not support this policy banning immigrants. These people live in our right and left. Have you ever thought about it? First of all, this is also an obligation. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked on the day when he was making the final sermon, did I make the communication iblaq to you of the message that Allah gave me? Everybody said yes. And then he asked, now it is the responsibility of you and people after you to take it to the people that exist around you. So that's a responsibility that we need to fulfill. With our good conduct, good manner, just a smile, a hello, a child who belongs to your neighbor saying hi, sometime taking a small gift, connecting to our neighbors is very important. Because a friend of mine asked me this question 2-3 days ago. He said, he was a Muslim, but he asked me, why doesn't Allah defeat all these people who are causing this trouble to us? Well, Allah has established a sunnah. He has said, وَلَوْ يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ لَنْ تَصَرَ مِنْهُمْ وَلَاكِنْ لِيَبْلُوَ بَعْضَكُمْ بِبَعْضٍ. If Allah would have willed, he would have helped you and defeated your enemy. But Allah wants to test you. Our test is, how do we respond? And also, Allah has said in the same Quran, لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. That Allah is not going to help you change your destiny until you make an effort. So, improving our iman, our faith, connecting to Quran, connecting to Sunnah, making more nawafils, spending more in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then doing all of these things. So, we need to do all of these things. Because when a companion of the Prophet ﷺ came in the masjid, he asked, how did you come? He said, I came on a camel. Where is your camel? I left it outside, tawakkul Allah. The Prophet ﷺ said, go and tie the camel and then make tawakkul. So we have to develop the best strategy for the Muslim community. Use all the media, all the PR, all the dawah, everything that exists. And of course, everything matters only when our relationship with our Rabb is strong. When we care about our 5 daily prayers, additional prayers, when we read Quran, when we open our wallets and donate in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I pray to Allah that He gives us tawfiq and the wisdom of Quran and the love of the sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and protect us from all the evils. Aqulu qawli hadha, astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa li sa'il al-muslimin walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin, was salatu was salam ala rasulihil kareem. So in regard to what we need to do, if you remember last week, there was an announcement that every single penny that you will donate, it will go to the security of the masjid. Alhamdulillah, you donated more than $8,000. And I just want to share with you that IFS has hired a professional security guard who is on premises from Fajr until 10:30 p.m. 7 days a week. This will cost more than $30,000 for just 2 months. And the security committee is planning to enhance the security by buying equipment, more cameras, more things. All of this is going to cost about $200,000 more. And this is necessary. This is necessary. Allah has obligated us that we protect everybody who comes to this masjid. We have to do all these things, then inshallah, with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will protect us. As He did not leave the people of Musa alayhi salam, as He did not leave our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi salam. So His help is going to come to us, but we have to prove that we believe in Him, our faith is strong, and we are doing everything that we need to do. قال الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد بعدد من صلى وصام اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد بعدد من قاد وقام. اللهم صل على جميع الانبياء والمرسلين وعلى سائر الصحابه والتابعين وعلى عبادك الصالحين. اللهم ايد الاسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وجعلنا منهم. واخذل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجلنا منهم. اللهم ارنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وارنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم ثبتنا على الاسلام. اللهم نور قلوبنا بنور الايمان. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات الاحياء منهم والاموات. عباد الله رحمكم الله، ان الله يعمر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم ودوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله تعالى اعلى واولى وعز وجل واتم واهم واكبر. اقم الصلاه.
الله اكبر الله اكبر الله اكبر الله اكبر. اشهد ان لا اله الا الله اشهد ان لا اله الا الله. اشهد ان محمد رسول الله اشهد ان محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاه حي على الصلاه حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
Please make sure that your lines are straight and there are no gaps. And let's pray that Allah accept our prayer. And let's pray with all the khushu and khuzu. It could be our last prayer. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. إن أصحاب الجنة اليوم في شغل فاكهون، هم وأزواجهم في ظلال على الأرائك متكئون، لهم فيها فاكهة ولهم ما يدعون، سلام قولا من رب رحيم. وامتازوا اليوم أيها المجرمون، ألم أعهد إليكم يا بني آدم أن لا تعبدوا الشيطان، إنه لكم عدو مبين، وأن اعبدوني هذا صراط مستقيم. ولقد أضل منكم جبلا كثيرا، أفلم تكونوا تعقلون، هذه جهنم التي كنتم توعدون، اصلوها اليوم بما كنتم تكفرون. الله أكبر. الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
عرفت الجنة للمتقين غير بعيد هذا ما توعدون لكل أواب حفيظ من خشي الرحمن بالغيب وجاء بقلب منيب ادخلوها بسلام ذلك يوم الخلود لهم ما يشاءون فيها ولدينا مزيد الله أكبر الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
جزاك الله خير دكتور صديقي may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and accept your work mashallah Dr. Siddiqui works very closely with the Gain Peace organization a local mashallah community leader with regards to da'wah getting the message out to our neighbors and our co-workers and billboards and lots of da'wah material mashallah so if you have any questions feel free to talk to Dr. Siddiqui after the salah. Brother Jawed Aslam will also be in the outside in the lobby. If you have any information, if you have any questions on how you can support financially, including their dinner, which is coming up tomorrow night, alhamdulillah. Some announcements for the foundation community. Next Friday, or tonight, inshallah, we'll be having our next Real Talk program. Real Talk is the Islamic Foundation Youth's initiative for high school and college age boys and girls. We'll be meeting tonight, the month for February. We're going to be talking about family first. So your high school age, college, high school and college age boys and girls from 6 to 8 here at the Islamic Foundation. We'll come through. We'll have a short discussion, huge Q&A session. Usually that's the most entertaining part of it. And of course we'll have some food and some companionship as well. Alhamdulillah. That is tonight and in 2 Fridays from now. Next Friday, the Islamic Foundation Youth is also providing a event for awareness given our brothers and sisters in this community who face disabilities. So what it's like to be deaf or hearing impaired, physically impaired, other limitations that make it difficult for individuals to access the masjid, access Islamic knowledge. You'll have an opportunity next Friday to hear from those brothers and sisters themselves. So you can ask them questions. I know sometimes one of the main questions a lot of able-bodied individuals have is, how can I help? Or even how do I approach? Or do I even talk about this? Or do I just ignore it? Put all of those fears and concerns to rest. Hear from our own brothers and sisters with disabilities. Have them explain to you specifically what it is that they need, what it is that they want, and how each and every one of us can help form this beautiful and united ummah. That is going to be next Friday. Flyers are going to be passed out there in the lobby as well, alhamdulillah. And as is mentioned, mashallah, the security enhancements have been made. We do need to continue to contribute towards those expenses. Alhamdulillah, there will be someone collecting in the lobby. From the almost 20,000, mashallah, that was collected, alhamdulillah, we do want to give a special thanks to a particular brother who wanted to maintain anonymity, but gave 5,000 of that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect him the way he's helping to help protect our community. And may Allah keep all of us safe. May we stay aware, keep informed, stay on top of the current events. Make sure that you are protecting yourself not only spiritually, but also physically and materially. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless each and every one of you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد واهتدى ومن يعص الله ورسوله فإنه قد غوى لا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئا. إخوتي الكرام، إن خير الكتاب كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، خير الأمور عوازمها وشر الأمور محدثاتها، كل محدثة بدعة، كل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أوصي نفسي وإياكم بتقوى الله. قال سبحانه في كتابه المجيد: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. فنسأل الله يجعلني وإياكم من الفائزين في الدارين في الدنيا والآخرة. اللهم آمين. أما بعد. My dear respected brothers and sisters, beloved mothers and elders and little friends, by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we live another day. By the grace and beneficence of our Creator and Sustainer, we are given another opportunity to thank Allah for everything that we have. And while many of us want to complain, while many of us feel hurt, while many of us feel slighted, while many of us feel like second and third class citizens in our own country, while many of us want to voice these concerns, we must take our concerns to Allah first. Ibrahim alayhi salam, the Khalil of Allah, the friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when faced with difficulty, would turn to his Rabb. When everything seemed like it was against him,
Our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions in a hadith that when Ibrahim alayhi salam was literally in the fire, right, when he was thrown into this huge fire, the flames of which it's mentioned in hadith were burning birds well up in the sky. That's how hot this fire was. Ibrahim alayhi salam was sitting in that fire. Jibreel alayhi salam came to him and said, "Is there anything that you want me to help you with?" The fire is not a metaphor. Right, it was literally in fire, the hottest and most painful and tormentuous situation. Jibreel alayhi salam, the most powerful of the malaika, comes to Ibrahim and says, "Is there anything you want me to do? Do you want me to help you? Do you need something?" And Ibrahim alayhi salam, he turns to Jibreel and he says, "I don't need you. Hasbi Allah wa ni'mal wakeel." If you're going to complain to anybody, if you're going to voice your concern to anybody, and Jibreel is right there in front of you to listen to your complaint, to listen to what it is that you need, and he's ready to give it the moment you say it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired Ibrahim to say, "My help doesn't come from Jibreel. Help will not come from any creation, but it will come from Allah, who can tell fire, kuni bardan wa salam." Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can do this. The situation that we are in today will not be changed by politicians. The condition that our ummah is in will not be changed by financial contributions. The situation and the condition and the issues that you and I as a community are experiencing will not be changed by the person on your right or on your left. It will be changed only by the one who can proclaim kun fayakun. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says be, then that financial contribution has meaning. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says be, then the politician will make decisions on that are in your favor. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says be, that is when you and I can make a difference. My hand is useless, but that it was not for the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it effect change. The means are in front of us, and they are here for you and I to use. But do not forget where those means came from. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the beginning. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the end. Kun ma'a Allah wa la tubali. Be with Allah, and don't worry about the rest. Now I understand that that seems a little too simplistic. But this is happening here, and that ban is going on there, and this legislation is being passed here, and so-and-so is in the White House, and this is happening in this country, and that is it. How am I supposed to just trust on Allah? It really is just that simple. I'm sorry to break it to you. Islam is not a complicated matter. Deen, the religion of Allah, is not a complex matrix that you need to decode. It is simply La ilaha illallah. Nothing happens but that it is by the will of Allah. لَن يُصِيبُنَا إِلَّا. Right? Nothing will affect you. Nothing will come to you. Nothing will harm you. Nothing will benefit you except for that which كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for us. Ask the one who's doing the writing, not the one who's doing the reading. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your dua, your supplication has the potential to be way more powerful than you give it credit for. When you raise your hands and you lower your head and you call out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's deep. You are literally in a direct conversation with Rabbul Alameen. It's nothing short of that. If you feel like your dua is not being answered, if you feel like your dua is not up to par, if you feel like you're making dua lackadaisically or lazily, the way unfortunately we do a whole lot of things, then that can be corrected. And it needs to be corrected. But that shouldn't stop you from asking Allah, because Allah never grows tired of hearing from you. Rather, Allah loves to hear from you. So continue to do that which Allah loves. call upon your Lord. Connect yourself with Allah. Take the moments from your life that Allah gave you to begin with to call out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that which you want. We all want to see change in our lives. We all want a better situation for our families. We all want something to improve. None of us should be happy right now. I know that sounds grim, right? But none of us should be content with the status quo. Because the moment you're content, and I think I've said this before, and apologize if I'm offensive to anyone, right? But the moment you get content, the moment you get lazy, you get fat. You've got to stay on the move. You've got to stay trim. You've got to keep cut. You've got to keep going. The moment you are content with your life, your iman will get fat. The moment you think you've reached the pinnacle of your Islamic excellence, that is the moment Shaitan has you in his grip. Everyone in here, without a shadow of a doubt, has something that they want. Myself, first and foremost. We all want something. Now, how are you going to get it? You want the Muslim ban to end? Make dua. You want a prosperous future for your children? Make dua. You want wealth? Make dua. It is literally as simple as that. And I apologize for rehashing this for the next 15 minutes, but that is literally all that needs to be said. That is all that needs to be said. It is Allah in the beginning, and it is Allah in the end. It's up to you to make the connection. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in charge of all of the situations. You want wealth, ask Al-Ghani, the one whose wealth is incomprehensible to humanity. You want protection, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the ultimate protector. You want health, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is Ash-Shafi, the one who is perfect and complete in his giving of health and wellness. It has always been Allah, and it always will be Allah. You have to make the connection to Allah. As we look into politics today and we search our current events and we try to stay up to date on what's happening in society around us, it can get very overwhelming. Reports are coming out here and this is happening there and you can fill in the blanks, whoever. SubhanAllah, there's just so many things to get on, and I'm not here on the mimbar to be CNN and spit it all back to you. You have Twitter for that. But rather, well, I'll get to that another day. Not during the khutbah, please. You know what's going on in the world. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who created the world. Connect with Allah. Be with Allah. وَلَا تُبَالِي. And don't worry about the rest. My brothers and sisters, the apathy within our community must end. The lackadaisical approach that you and I as a community have taken, which is not from our Islamic roots, this is something that we have inherited culturally from Allahu A'lam where, I don't know. But the apathy that you and I have taken when we are confronted with these major issues must end. We have to. We must. We absolutely cannot afford but to be proactive. To get out there, to do something, you and I must first take that step towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our mother Maryam alayhi salam, in the pangs of childbirth, right? She's a young woman. She's unmarried. Her entire family, her entire community had cast her out because they thought ill of her. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raise her status even higher than she already is. But everybody had thought evil about her and they cast her aside from the community. She's alone. She's going through birth. She's tired. She's not well. She's about to deliver. I don't know what that's like, but I know it's ridiculously great. Like, subhanAllah al-Azim, the power and intensity that women have. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of the women of our community. Say ameen. In that instance, right, she wants just something, some sustenance, right? She wants just a date to eat. That's how tired and nauseated and all the feelings that are mixed up. Anybody that's been in a delivery room, you can tell. Just put that image in your head right now. Or maybe you've been trying to forget that image. Allahu a'lam. But whatever, imagine our mother Maryam alayhi salam, and she's under the palm tree and she's asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I want something to eat. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could very well have just made it rain dates. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala she's carrying the Masih. She's about to give birth to one of Ulul Azmi min al-Rusul. If anybody is going to be taken care of, if anybody is going to have abundance rain down upon her, it would have been Maryam alayhi salam. But what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell her to do? He tells her, "Fahuzzi ilayki bi jid'in nakhl." Right? Take your hand and put it on the trunk of the palm tree and shake the tree so that the dates will fall down. Has anyone here ever seen a palm tree, a date palm tree? Is it something that you can literally, like this microphone stand, catch and shake and you think something's going to fall out of the top of it? No. A date palm tree, right, you're talking about multiple feet in diameter. This thing is thick. I've seen people climb on date palm trees and dates won't fall down. So what is this weak, physically weakened woman in a state of childbirth going to do by shaking a date palm tree? Allah wanted her to make the effort. Put your hand out and things will come down. You can't just sit around and wait. That is not tawakkul. You cannot just sit in, we cannot remain in our little bubbles and think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to take care of everything on the outside. He will. It's just a matter of if you are going to be part of that solution. There are people that will attempt and will try to their utmost best to extinguish what is known as the light of Allah. يُرِيدُونَ لِيُطْفِئُوا نُورَ اللَّهِ بِأَفْوَاهِهِمْ. With their words, with their tweets, with their Facebook posts, with their messages, with their videos, with their propaganda, with their PR, they will try to extinguish the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاللَّهُ مُتِمُّ نُورِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will maintain that light. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect this religion. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect and reinforce the followers of this religion. وَلَوْ كَرِهَ الْكَافِرُونَ. Even to the dismay, even at the displeasure of those who reject Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's going to happen. Are you and I going to be a part of that, is the question. That's the only thing that's up for debate. Whether this religion succeeds or fails, that's not a question. It will succeed until the end of time. Whether or not Islam will be removed from the face of the earth, that's not a question. It will be here until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has Israfil blow the horn. That's not up for question. That's not up for debate. It's only a matter of, will you be a part of the Mahdi's army? Will you be a part of the soldiers of Allah? Will you be a part of the solution? And where does that solution lie? Allah. Try to consider your connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala right now. Try to consider that if you were to die right now, if you were to face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this instant, what would you have to show? If the angel was there in front of you, about ready to pass out the book of deeds, right? Which hand is he going to give it in? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala right now delivered the command, as he said in the Quran, اقرأ كتابك كفى بنفسك اليوم عليك حسيبا. Read your book. That's all you need. That's the end of the story. There's nothing beyond what's written here. What would my book tell today? What would your book tell today? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us the answer to that question. It's not rhetorical. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, wal asr, innal insana lafi khusr. If you and I were to face that moment today, we would be straight up at a loss. How to remedy that? How do you get past this? Because nobody wants to be a loser. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. That's the first step, is belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is way more than just lip service, way more than wearing a t-shirt, I am a Muslim, way more than registering on some database, way more than attending some lecture, way more than lips, it's way more than that. way more than having one of those cool things that hang from your rearview mirror that has all the names of Allah, which I absolutely adore those things. It's way more than that. It is iman, belief, that absolutely nothing happens but that it is by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then you follow that up, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. And then you do those good deeds. It's not belief alone and it's not action alone. They are joined by the wall, the connector. You believe, وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. And you do good deeds. You get out there and you help your community. You get out there and you participate and you volunteer and you get to know each other and you reach out as da'is, as callers to this religion, the way our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was tasked with doing from the very moment of Nubuwa. Ya ayyuhal muzammil, ya ayyuhal muddathir, qum, get up. You can't sit around anymore. Our Prophet was commanded to get up. Don't get up now until I say qumu li salatikum. But the moment you leave this masjid, the moment you salam out of your salah today, you start something. Get involved in your neighborhood. Go say hello to someone you've never said hello to before. Go follow up with somebody in your community that you know is ill. And if you don't know somebody in your neighborhood that's ill, that's on you, man, because you haven't reached out to them before. Take somebody a pack of cookies. Whatever it is that you need to do, say assalamu alaikum, smile at somebody. Whatever the case may be, we can all reach out in different ways. But the fact of the matter is that every single one of us needs to reach out. There are 1,000 people hearing this message right now. Imagine 1,000 efforts of da'wah here in the next 2 hours. The world would change. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase us in resolve, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to act upon this religion the way it is meant to be acted upon. And I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put it within our hearts to share the beauty of this faith with our family, to share the beauty and excellence of this faith with our neighbors and our community. And I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep each and every one of us safe and sound in all situations. اللهم آمين وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. قال سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه المجيد إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد بعدد من قعد وقام. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد بعدد من صلى وصام. اللهم صل على جميع إخوانه من النبيين وعلى سائر الصحابة والتابعين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وأدخلنا في جنتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم يا سامع الصوت يا كاسي العظام لحما بعد الموت أسألك يا رحمن أن تجعلنا وأهلنا من أصحاب الجنة الذين لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون وأن تعتق رقابنا من النار. My dear respected brothers and sisters, your security and your safety is one of the utmost concerns of the administration of this masjid and this community, alhamdulillah. The efforts that began last week, alhamdulillah, to hire the armed security guards from Fajr till 10:30 p.m. every single day for the next 2 months has already been initiated. You can see the security guards outside, alhamdulillah. They are here for your safety and for your security. The administration has approved a budget for this, which you have, alhamdulillah, contributed from last Friday until today in total of about $20,000. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you and bless you and keep you protected the way you have attempted to protect this community, mashallah. It doesn't end there, though. Okay, there's more than just 2 months of security. It's more than just a temporary having a security guard outside. These efforts must continue for the rest of the year through Ramadan continue to give today from that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you, that you will be protected. MashaAllah, one brother gave from the last week until now $5,000 himself. May Allah bless that brother, alhamdulillah. But each and every one of us has it within ourselves, and the responsibility within ourselves to contribute to this cause. The needs are still there. Close to $120,000 is what is projected to provide security updates as well as personnel for the rest of the year. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make that a means of ease for us and patience for us, that we can worship in this blessed country and in this beautiful land that we live in. Allahumma ameen. Ibadullah, rahimakumullah. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. قال سبحانه وتعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. عباد الله، اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أولى وأعز وأجل وأهم وأتم وأكبر، فأقيموا الصلاة وصلوا صلاة مودع.
الله أكبر الله